Ben Simmons. You know the name. It's the name of a talented young man accused of making his team lose. And yet, the story started so well. But everything fell apart in a few moments against the Atlanta Hawks. What the hell happened to Ben Simmons? The Rise. Simmons grew up in Melbourne, Australia. There, he left all traditional national sports behind and turned to basketball. And very quickly, his skills started to attract plenty of attention. In 2013, he moved to the United States to continue his development. And 2 years later, he was receiving notable awards. Mr. Basketball USA, Naismith Prep Player of the Year, to name a few. His great performances also allowed him to join an established university, the LSU Tigers. There, Ben Simmons recorded impressive statistics, and his reputation grew further. In 2016, he declared for the NBA draft. And shortly after, the Philadelphia 76ers secured his talents with the first overall pick. All of a sudden, Simmons was one of the main pieces of the 76ers' The Process rebuild. He had the pressure of representing Australia on a national level, and now the prestigious city of Philadelphia. Unfortunately, he didn't play in his first season due to injury, but when his time came, he dazzled many with his style of play, forming an unstoppable duo with fellow star and teammate Joel Embiid. He was part of the modern point forward era, being an incredibly fast, strong player capable of controlling a game by himself. Many compared Simmons to the great LeBron James. Yes, he was rated that highly. Simmons was an elite defender, able to stop any opponent. After their last title win in 1983, he was seen as the player that could propel Philadelphia back to the top. The Fall. Since 2018, the Sixers have made it to the playoffs after going 5 seasons previously with no postseason action. But in their recent return to the big time, the 76ers still haven't made it to the Eastern Conference Finals. Of course, Joel Embiid can't score 45 points per game. And with that, other players have to take responsibility. Well, that's not the case with Ben Simmons. At least, it wasn't recently against the Atlanta Hawks. One particular play has been talked about and has been on constant replay, again and again and again. Simmons was free for a dunk, all alone under the basket, and he gave up the ball to a teammate who failed to score. I'll be honest, I thought the turning point was when we had an open shot and we made one free throw. The Cameroonian openly denounced the decision of his teammate, and he was right to do so because Ben Simmons refused to shoot in a critical moment in the series. Throughout the 7 games, Simmons only attempted 3 shots in the final quarter of games, and that is clearly detrimental. Michael Scott would only say one thing to this: you miss 100% of the shots you don't take. Ben Simmons, on the other hand, might respond differently by saying the opposite: you don't miss 100% of the shots you don't take. The situation has sent analysts and fans into a frenzy. They simply don't understand the mindset behind Simmons' decisions. For them, it seems unacceptable that a basketball player is afraid to take shots. The future. All this Kobe Bryant had announced in 2019. He's got to get a jump shot. It sounds stupid and all that, but I'm dead serious. Because if not, he will regret it when his career is over. I think his development will come in shooting, obviously. At some point, he's got to be able to shoot that ball. But then, how should we see the future of the Philadelphia 76ers? They've been stagnant for quite a few years now and have been failing to progress. But above all, what about the future of Ben Simmons? He can be an asset for a franchise and can also be a burden. Unreliable at the free throw line, and he's an incredibly inefficient shooter in general. Simmons must change to help his teammates. LeBron James has worked on his shortcomings to become even more dominant. If Simmons arms himself with a shot of any kind, he could wreak havoc on defenses. All is not lost, however, and we must believe that things can change. After all, we must not forget one thing: it's always sunny in Philadelphia.